wondered what it would be like to live life as a toon? Well, here's your chance. Jump online and straight into Toontown, where the city limits are as wide as your imagination. Start by creating your own unique identity and turn yourself into the toon you always wanted to be. Sweet. Now you're ready to leap into a world of Disney magic. Burst into a never-ending adventure across outrageous new lands. Don't just stand around looking. Get into the action!
That's right, today we are looking at Toontown Online, or just Toontown, if you want to be normal about it. It was a 2003 massively multiplayer RPG developed by Disney's virtual reality studio and Shell Games. The game officially launched on June 2nd, 2003, although there was a beta running from 2001 to 2002. The game was available on Windows and Mac computers. Interestingly enough, Shell Games would go on to work on something quite interesting in the future, the VR version of Among Us. To summarise the game, you as the player created a character known as a toon, and you used weapons known as gags, which were like comedy items like pies, to fight and destroy cogs, which are like corporate robot businessmen, who were the bad guys of the game, which is quite fitting from a corporate company such as Disney. Now, before we dive into the gameplay of Toontown, please don't forget to click the like button and subscribe and tap the bell for notifications to see more videos based on old games. Now, please note the gameplay you are about to see, aside from this trailer, is not actually from the original Toontown Online. This is because Toontown Online actually shut down in 2013.
I've got nothing left! I've got nothing left!
Leaving behind a decade of childhood memories and entertainment. The gameplay you are in fact seeing is from a fan version called Toontown Rewritten, which was created not that long after the servers originally shut down. It has most of the game's original assets, except this doesn't have any ties with Disney itself.
You just saved me. I'm free.
Okay, so gameplay-wise, there's actually quite a lot to break down. First off, let's talk about the combat in the game, as that is the central part of Toontown. As I mentioned before, the corporate businessmen, or the cogs, are the antagonists of the game. They come in four different varieties: cell bots, cash bots, law bots, and boss bots. And as you progress through the game, their levels obviously got higher, with increased health and damage.
Upgrade in progress.
Now, when you actually fight the cogs, it is a turn-based combat game. Start off with basic gags and a 15-point laugh meter, which is essentially 15 health points, and the gags are your attacks. The two basic gags are a squirt flower and a pie, with a bomb in it. And then as you would progress through the game, you would unlock more gags in certain fields, so you'd have better pies, better squirts, and many different gags as well. To initiate these turn-based fights, all you had to do was literally walk up to one of the cogs patrolling the streets of Toontown. If your laugh meter hit zero, however, that would be the end of the fight. You would turn sad, which is essentially just death. Your toon would literally get sad and die. Quite relatable, I find. Now, other than combat, there's actually quite a lot to do in Toontown Online. Whilst cogs roam most of the areas of Toontown, each area has its own specific place that's called a playground. These playgrounds do not have any cogs that spawn and are perfectly safe to roam around. In these playgrounds, there were lots of things you could do, ranging from fishing, to shopping, to lots and lots of different mini-games. There's a whole area that just has mini-golf, there's a kart racing section. Honestly, there is a lot to do here. There are also quests that can be received, and these can be completed and they will give you extra health / laugh points.
Uh-oh! What would you do? If you pick C, you're ready for Toontown! The outrageous, ever-changing online game. You can join your friends in exciting boss battles, crazy mini-games, and new Toon parties. With your parents' permission, get non-stop 3D adventure and play for free at Toontown.com. Toontown, rated E for everyone.
Are you Toon enough?
Honestly, the marketing campaign of this game was absolutely unhinged, but also gives me so much nostalgia at the same time. Now, before we dive any further into the history or facts or any other weird things that Toontown might have brought us, let's just divert a second and talk about Toontown from a visual perspective. Now, bearing in mind this game did launch in 2003, I think it actually looks really nice. The game was designed to run on pretty much any computer that could run a game, so it couldn't be too graphically intensive. And also, again, it was 2003, so we can't really be expecting PS5 levels of quality. But the Toon aesthetic is just done really well. It's pretty to look at, it's colourful, vibrant, just a really nice game to look at.
Oh my god, it's so pretty! It's so pretty, bro, look yes. at it!
Now, interestingly, we never actually knew how many players exactly were on Toontown Online originally. Jesse Schell, one of the developers of the game, said that it was classified how many toons were on Toontown in regards to its current population. Now, some users report seeing up to 16,000 toons online at once, and signups are definitely upwards of 2 million, but we never actually have an official statistic. Now, Toontown Rewritten, so the fan version of the game, according to MMOstats.com, has an estimated 17,900 players daily, with an estimated 1.3 million players in total. And this is all since the original has shut down, so in the last 9 years. Which is really impressive that even to this day, there are 17,000 people playing this game. Now, whilst we're on the topic of Toontown Rewritten, the Rewritten team have been doing some amazing work in terms of preservation. I'll put the link below, but there's a Toontown Preservation project where they're getting artwork, developmental notes, merchandise history and everything sent in by developers and various people, all to be logged in one area. Now, as this was Disney, there was obviously quite a lot of merchandise. There was a range of pins, there was bobbleheads, watches, mouse pads, clocks, even a calculator. But interestingly enough, you could buy custom t-shirts and hoodies from the Disney website where you could upload a picture of your own toon and have it printed on a t-shirt and sent to you. Now, as Toontown was an early 2000s online MMORPG, it obviously had a subscription model. So there was the free version, which did get revamped several times. Initially, you could basically do nothing except the tutorial and the areas surrounding that. But that eventually got revamped so that you could basically do most of the game just without access to certain areas, such as the boss levels and stuff like that. Now, the paid version obviously had unlimited access and certain VIP benefits. But one thing you could opt into was receiving trading cards monthly, along with a newsletter. Now, these weren't just sent via email, these were actual physical cards you received in the post. Which I think is really cool and something different for the time that it came out. They aren't really worth too much now, but it's just a cool bit of trivia and history to hold on to. Now that we've spoken about the gameplay, the graphics, the history, and even the preservation, takes us towards the sad part of Toontown Online's original story, the shutdown.
No.
Now, sadly, on August 20th, 2013, Disney announced that after 10 years, Toontown Online was going to be shut down permanently the following month. During this month, every player was given membership for free for the remaining time until it closed. There was lots of in-game events and celebrations that took place as well. Now obviously what followed was a lot of petitions going against the closure, but eventually September 19th did roll around and the game did shut down, along with the website which has now been archived. It will just redirect you to Disney.com. Now, following the closure, shortly after, several different versions of the game were revived by fans, most notably Toontown Rewritten, as I've spoken about earlier in the video. Jesse Schell, the developer, hinted that Toontown Online closed due to it becoming unsustainable with its business model, aka it being a subscription-based downloadable RPG in the 2010s. This just wasn't really the trend anymore. Now, there were rumours that Microsoft was interested in buying Toontown Online if they could make it into a more mobile-friendly version, but that never came into fruition. Now, most people do believe that Disney have completely abandoned Toontown Online, but that actually wasn't the case. They have hosted several internal meetings to talk about the future of the game, referring to mobile games and payment options available, but nothing has yet come out of that. The last known discussion about this was in 2017, but that is still promising, seeing as that was 4 years after the game closed, and I'm sure there might have been more discussions that haven't been made public about it since. Who knows, perhaps at some point in the future we may see Toontown return officially and not through fanways, but that's anyone's guess. Now that's really it for today in my discussion of Toontown. Now, if you guys want to check the game out yourself, I've attached the link to Toontown Rewritten in the description below, as well as the link to the preservation website also. Now, thank you very much for watching. Please don't forget to click the like button, subscribe, and tap the bell for notifications for more videos on old games. I look forward to seeing you in next week's video.